Hey, good to see you again. Now, we have different types of Bible translation. You have the Sahid, the Tinogo, the French, numerous types of Bible translation. And we also have the Pidgin Bible translation. Now, speaking about the Pidgin Bible translation, if you live here in Nigeria, you'll understand that Pidgin language is one of the most popular languages here in Nigeria that we use as a means of communication. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how to install Pidgin Bible translation on your Easyworship server.
Ethnogeship and EDMT, darkness can cover water, and the Spirit of God can they move on top the water, on top the face of the water.
Now, the sad thing is, this cannot be done on the Easyworship 9. You can only install the Pidgin Bible translation for those using the Easyworship 7. I'm going to show you how to properly do that so your audience can read along as you project the Pidgin Bible translation on the screen. Now, if you're using the Easyworship 9, you can also upgrade to Easyworship 7 for you to be able to do this. Just coming across this channel for the first time, or you haven't subscribed, remember, smash that red subscribe button below and also turn on the notification bell so YouTube will notify you first whenever I upload videos like this on this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, give this video a thumbs up if you love it so YouTube algorithm can also recommend it to other people on the YouTube community that would want to be part of our little family here. And without any further ado, let me show you how to properly install the Pidgin Bible translation on your Easyworship 7. Let's dive into it.
The first thing that you're going to do is to go ahead and open your web browser, okay? So if you're using Chrome or Firefox, whichever one you're using, open that and search for Easyworship 7, okay? So search for Easyworship 7 and then you open the first link, that's the support.easyworship.com, that is the official link, okay? So open that particular one. Then once you open that, scroll down to you see download Easyworship 7. So click on the download button and to start downloading immediately. So I'm just going to give you some seconds for you to finish downloading so that we can start the process together. I want to take you through the whole thing step by step so you understand how you can properly do this, okay? They said it's remaining about 25 seconds. My internet is actually fast today, thank God. It won't take long for it to finish downloading. Just in the next 10 seconds is to finish downloading so that we can go ahead and install it together. Okay, so I'm just going to give you some seconds for it to load. Though I already have Easyworship 7 running on my PC, but just for the purpose of this tutorial, I want us to go through the whole process together step by step, okay? And I urge you to watch the video from beginning to the end so that you can understand all the steps required for you to be able to download the Pidgin Bible translation on the Easyworship 7, okay? I'm just going to click here, and this is the Easyworship here you have on the screen. So I'm just going to double-click on it. Yeah, so you can either double-click on it like this, or you can just right-click with your mouse, click on either open or run as administrator. So whichever one you do, it's still fine, okay? You can either run it as administrator or you just open it. Whichever of them that you choose to do is still fine. So just click on OK, next, and then install. So it's currently installing right now. So I'm just going to give it some seconds again for it to finish installing. You have the 4.7.4.1.9. And the best thing is you can actually do this with any version of Easyworship 7. So long as it's Easyworship 7, you can be able to do this. But if it's Easyworship 9, then you won't be able to do this. All you have to do is just to install the Easyworship 7 on your PC. If you have 9 running there already, then you'll be able to download the Bible translations. Okay, that's for the Pidgin. Just going to remove it from live. And let's close this window. And the next thing you're going to do is to go over to Scriptures. And once you're in Scriptures, go over to More Available. See this More Available down here? Click on the More Available and scroll down. So scroll down to you see Nigeria Pidgin Bible. Let's just scroll down. You see Nigeria Pidgin Bible. And that is it here. Nigeria Pidgin Bible. So it's actually free. So you don't have to, you know, buy it. It's just 100% free. So click on it and it's currently downloading. I'm just going to give it some seconds for it to download and wait for it. Yeah, so it's currently downloading. So let's just give it some seconds and it's already installed. And if you check here, CPIG, that's the Pidgin Bible. See, click on here. You can see here, it's currently displaying on the screen. So let's just go to edit here Go to options. And let's change the screen from, okay, custom position. You already have custom position. I'm just going to put it on the NDI stream so that we can run it on vMix. Let me show you how it looks like. Okay. So click on OK. It's on NDI stream right now. Click on OK. Click on any of them. And let's pop on our vMix software so that you can see how it's looking. Okay, so the Pidgin Bible translation is already running. So I just wanted to display it on vMix. So you can actually link it up together with vMix as well. So go over to NDI and desktop capture. And then you see the Easyworship live here. See, this is it on the screen. Let's bring it back to life. And you can see how it is here. Ethnogeship and EDMT. Darkness can cover water. And the Spirit of God can they move on top of the water, on top of the face of the water. Can see this is actually very useful, okay, for the local church. And for you have the old mummies, the old daddies who doesn't understand English but understand Pidgin very well. You can actually use this for them. The man of God or the preacher for the local church can actually make use of this for better translation, so they can also understand the message that he's trying to pass across to them. So let's give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful, and let me know what you think about it, okay? Well, and let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe and also turn on the notification bell so YouTube will notify you first whenever I upload videos like this on this channel. And signing out, just stay tuned because we are fully back right now and we're dropping back-to-back updates to every one of you. Thank you very much for staying tuned, and I love you all. Thank you.